Nine Mens Morris is a strategy board game for two players dating at least to the Roman Empire. The game is also known as Nine Man Morris, Mill, Mills, The Mill Game, Merrills, Merrills, Merrells, Merrells, Merrells and Nine Penny Marl in English. The game has also been called Cowboy Checkers and is sometimes printed on the back of checkerboards. Nine Mens Morris is a solved game, one in which either player can force the game into a draw. Its name derives from the Latin word, game piece. Three main alternative variations of the game are 3, 6, and 12 Mens Morris. The board consists of a grid with 24 intersections or points. Each player has 9 pieces, or men, usually colored black and white. Players try to form mills, 3 of their own men lined horizontally or vertically, allowing a player to remove an opponent's man from the game. A player wins by reducing the opponent to 2 pieces, or by leaving them without a legal move. The game proceeds in 3 phases. The game begins with an empty board. The players determine who plays first, then take turns placing their men one per play on empty points. If a player is able to place 3 of their pieces on contiguous points in a straight line, vertically or horizontally, they have formed a mill and may remove one of their opponent's pieces from the board on the game, with the caveat that a piece in an opponent's mill can only be removed if no other pieces are available. After all men have been placed, phase 2 begins. Players continue to alternate moves, this time moving a man to an adjacent point. A piece may not jump another piece. Players continue to try to form mills and remove their opponent's pieces as in phase 1. A player can break a mill by moving one of his pieces out of an existing mill, then moving it back to form the same mill a second time, each time removing one of his opponent's men. The act of removing an opponent's man is sometimes called pounding the opponent. When one player has been reduced to 3 men, phase 3 begins. When a player is reduced to 3 pieces, there is no longer a limitation on that player of moving to only adjacent points. The player's men may fly from any point to any vacant point. Some rules sources say this is the way the game is played, some treat it as a variation, and some do not mention it at all. A 19th century games manual calls this the truly rustic mode of playing the game. Flying was introduced to compensate when the weaker side is one man away from losing the game. At the beginning of the game, it is more important to place pieces in versatile locations rather than to try to form mills immediately and make the mistake of concentrating one's pieces in one area of the board. An ideal position, which typically results in a win, allows a player to shuttle one piece back and forth between wool mills, removing a piece every turn. Three Mens Morris, also called Nine Holes, is played on the points of a grid of 2x2 squares, or in the squares of a grid of 3x3 squares, as in tic-tac-toe. The game is for two players, each player has 3 men. The players put one man on the board in each of their first 3 plays, winning if a mill is formed. After that, each player moves one of his men, according to one of the following rules versions. A player wins by forming a mill. H.J.R. Murray calls version number 1 9 holes, and version number 2 3 Mens Morris or the smaller Merrills. 6 Mens Morris gives each player 6 pieces and is played without the outer square of the board for 9 Mens Morris. Flying is not permitted. The game was popular in Italy, France and England during the Middle Ages but was obsolete by 1600. This board is also used for 5 Mens Morris. 7 Mens Morris uses this board with a cross in the center. 12 Mens Morris adds 4 diagonal lines to the board and gives each player 12 pieces. This means the board can be filled in the placement stage. If these happens, the game is a draw. This variation on the game is popular amongst rural youth in South Africa where it is known as Morabruba and is now recognized as a sport in that country. H.J.R. Murray also calls the game the larger Merrills. This board is also used for 11 Mens Morris. This variant was invented by Emmanuel Lasker, chess world champion from 1894 to 1921. It is based on Thurles of 9 Mens Morris, but there are 2 differences. Each player gets 10 pieces, and pieces can be moved in the first phase already. This means each player can choose to either place a new piece or to move one of his pieces already on the board. This variant is more complex than 9 Mens Morris, and draws are less likely. According to R.C. Bell, the earliest known board for the game includes diagonal lines and was cut into the roofing slabs of the temple at Kurna in Egypt. He estimated a date for them of BCE. However, Friedrich Berger wrote that some of the diagrams at Kurna include Coptic crosses, making it doubtful that the diagrams date to 1400 BCE. Berger concluded, certainly they cannot be dated. One of the earliest mentions of the game may be in Ovid's Ars Amatoria. In Book 3, after discussing a popular board game, Ovid wrote there is another game divided into as many parts as there are months in the year. A table has three pieces on either side. The winner must get all the pieces in a straight line. It is a bad thing for a woman not to know how to play, for love often comes into being during play. Berger believes the game was probably well known by the Romans, as there are many boards on Roman buildings, even though dating them is impossible because the buildings have been easily accessible since they were built. It is possible that the Romans were introduced to the game via trade routes, but this cannot be proven. The game might have been played by the sculptors while they were building the huge temples. Inscriptions are seen in many places, carved on stone. The game peaked in popularity in medieval England. Boards have been found carved into the cloister seats at the English cathedrals at Canterbury, Gloucester, Norwich, Salisbury, and Westminster Abbey. These boards used holes, not lines, to represent the nine spaces on the board, hence the name Nine Holes, and forming a diagonal row did not win the game. Another board is carved into the base of a pillar in Chester Cathedral and Chester. Giant outdoor boards were sometimes cut into village greens. In Shakespeare's 17th century work A Midsummer Night's Dream, Titania refers to such a board. The nine men's morris is filled up with mud. Some authors say the game's origin is uncertain. It has been speculated that its name may be related to morris dances, and hence to Moorish, but according to Daniel King, the word morris has nothing to do with the Old English dance of the same name. It comes from the Latin word, which means a counter or gaming piece. King also notes that the game was popular among Roman soldiers. In some European countries, the design of the board was given special significance as a symbol of protection from evil, and to the ancient Celts, the Morris Square was sacred. At the center lay the holy mill or cauldron, a symbol of regeneration, and emanating out from it, the four cardinal directions, the four elements and the four winds. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.